Dumbest Sports Talk worldwide with some news in the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, I got to scope them heavyweights. Got something to scope going under the radar. In Monaco, they're going to have it on the 24th. Saturday, they're going to have some good fights going on. But actually, you know, the headliner upsets me anyway because Dennis Lebedev is headlining. Dennis Lebedev is that cruiserweight who didn't enter the the 8 WBSS tournament that Alexander Usyk was in. You know, Garcia was in it. Doherty Kos was in it. You know, Marco Huck. Everybody, Maurice Brightus, well, everybody was in it, and Dennis Lebedev wasn't. So really, I'm irked at him right now. He's going to be headlining fighting somebody, so I didn't really read it until he gets and fight somebody like that. He needs to fight not Usyk. You don't deserve that. Go fight Brightus or Dordicus or something, then we can talk again. But anyway, what is interesting and going under the radar is who I'm going to start calling the giant killer, Michael Hunter, right? Michael Hunter now, he's 15-1 with 10 KOs, right? Moving up from that cruiserweight division. That one loss comes to Alexander Usyk. Alexander Usyk, you can lose to. This is the only undisputed guy in all of boxing, right? And just beat up Tony Bellew. Right, so and hasn't fought any of them at home, none of them. So for me, he's one of the most awesome guys in boxing right now because he doesn't do it in the comfort of his own area. He goes to your area, your backyard, and handles his business. Show me anyone else that's doing that or even wants to do that. Then we can talk. If not, don't push up on Alexander Usyk because he's an anomaly. Okay, period. So, but Michael Hunter is somebody who, you know, he just came off that win against your boy, Martin Bocoli. Now, Martin Bocoli, you know, people try to, but he's 6'6", you know, about 250 pounds, and he was sparring Anthony Joshua and doing a damn good job. I've seen what he was basically saying. He don't want to say how well he was doing, but everyone that's talking about it says he does well when he's sparring Anthony Joshua. He was about to get hyped. He's come from Congo, I think it is. But he's based in Scotland, and they hyping him. You know, they was about to hype the dude. Michael Hunter came up for cruiserweight and beat him. Okay, stopped him late. That was about a month ago. Now, Michael Hunter is about to go and fight another behemoth on short notice. Alexander Ustinov. You know, he's lost about two fights, Ustinov. But he was about to fight the big guy from China, Zhang Zhili, or whatever his name is. You know, the big guy from China ain't lost, really, real big behemoth. He was about to fight him. He's had visa problems. This guy steps in on like a week and a half notice, if not less than that, to fight this guy Usyk in Monaco. Be careful. If he wins this one too, watch out. He's a giant killer. Because, see, what happens to people like that is we, on the outside, don't really know what's going on in sparring. But sparring partners are boxers, and they talk to each other. And if a sparring partner come in and they talk to another boxer, he probably won't talk to a reporter and tells him what's going on in sparring. But he's coming home after sparring, and you know, I just said, shoot, me and Anthony Joshua, we went at it. Yeah, okay, Anthony Joshua, he probably was taking it a little easy on me, whatever. But I was up in there. You get hyped about that. It's just like if you was a basketball player or a soccer player or something, and you had a good training. You go home talking about it, happy, don't you? Have a good weekend and everything. So that's what's going on. And so Bacoli's like, man, I've been handling Joshua pretty well. So Michael Hunter goes in there and beats him in a fight. He's feeling good about himself because he's thinking, well, shoot, I only lost to Usyk. And when I fought Usyk, I had a year break. So this guy's feeling good about himself to take a fight against Usyk because Usyk can get close to 300 pounds, guys. And he's about 6'7". So, you know, to go in there as a crew just got up in the heavyweight, he ain't going to be more than 220. Going in here messing around with Usyk, so small, after taking care of Bacoli, be careful. We need to just keep an eye on this guy. And I'm going to really, really follow that fight. I'm anxious to watch that to see if he can get through this fight, too. Because if he does, it's something special. And you know, everybody can't be the very best, right? We don't just want to talk about the very best in the division. This is a guy who is handling his business. And we need to keep our eye on him, keep our antenna up. So remember, I told you now, Michael Hunter going to fight Alexander Usyk on 24th in Monaco. Get your clocks together, wherever you are in the world. If you can watch that fight, keep an eye on this little guy. All right? Dope Sports Talk. Worldwide. And I'm about to hear y'all.